you. Any questions for Sarah? Okay. Any questions for me? About hours? About anything? Okay, so at this point, Science Sidekicks, Dia does that, and NHS, on the reminder, we'll put it out when there's, give you the information when Science Sidekicks will be meeting. Okay, Ms. Stout, whoever is going to be doing this, would you have maybe one row come up so that they can see how they're going to come up?
Yeah, let's have the second row, because we already decided first row, so we did it again. So, second row on this side, which is fake third row, could you guys please stand?
We're good.
Please stand for the posting of the colors to the alma mater.
Please join us in singing the alma mater.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this National Honor Society induction ceremony. I can't tell you, one, the pride that I have to see all of you here, one, just the joy to actually be able to come together again like we used to do. It's amazing, and I hope you're enjoying this as well. I do want to say to the people at home, congratulations to you as well. None of this would be possible without your support and the support of your child and your student. To the choir who already dismissed, I have a little bit of a tear in my eye because I sure have missed hearing our what I call the angels on campus. Great job with that. ROTC, the posting of the colors, I miss that so much too. Thank you for that. A lot of people to thank, I did have to write it down because I know I'll forget to name somebody, but I do want all of you to understand that when we decided to do this, this is for you. And when we decided to do this with Ms. Moorhead, there were a number of faculty members that came on board and gave of their time to make this possible for you. So thank you, Mr. Stevens, Mr. Hyde, Ms. Swallow, Mr. Allen, who I also think today is his birthday, so tell him happy birthday if you see him later. Ms. Jones, Ms. Lawrence, Ms. Stout, we've already recognized the choir and ROTC. NHS officers who are lined up on the side and on the stage, thank you as well. And inductees, the last thing that I want to say is congratulations again, but I also want to say, listen to the words when they get up here to talk about the criteria to be a member of National Honor Society, because it is so much more than grades. In fact, I would say grades is the least of all the criteria. So pay attention to that, and congratulations.
Hi, on behalf of all of National Honor Society, I wanted to welcome you to the induction this year. Your presence as candidates for the National Honor Society has shown that you exemplify the spirit of our school and community with your commitment to leadership and service, and your instructors have recognized that. Honor societies are not a new concept. Ancient universities, as well as current ones, have honor societies to recognize people who rise above in service and leadership. Your instructors are recognizing you for achievements that you've already made, but they're also still expecting you to keep making those achievements. They're expecting you to continue to represent the ideals of our school and community, and your parents are at home watching you for this achievement. I now present the Chairman of Purpose to tell you a little bit about the purpose of our National Honor Society.
The Constitution of the National Honor Society recognizes four main objectives as fundamental in education: character, leadership, scholarship, and service. To hold these ideals ever before the school as objects towards which all should strive for the purpose of this society. Our aims are to encourage all students to develop scholarly habits, to enlist in service, to offer leadership, and to advance the welfare of the school.
Now I invite the emblem bearer to talk about the emblem of National Honor Society.
The emblem of the society is the keystone of the Flaming Church. The keystone bears at its base the letter CSLS, which stands for the principles of its organization: character, scholarship, leadership, and service. The Flaming Torch is symbolic of our search for truth. It is to lead others in life, to keep burning our society a high ambition for the enduring values of life. It indicates our desire to serve with unselfish loyalty, both truth and honor.
Now that we've heard from the Chairman of Purpose and the Emblem Bearer, I want to direct everyone's attention to the four pillars of National Honor Society: scholarship, service, leadership, and character. First, the Chairman of Scholarship is going to talk to you about them.
Scholarship is the shining goal for which every student has been striving. Through scholarship, life can become more valuable and beautiful for a person who is better able to enrich his life and the lives of others. Scholarship is available to most people, but it may not be had merely for the asking. Anyone who desires it must put forth hard and tireless effort. Scholarship is symbolized in our society by the strive to increase it and make it serve you. It is more valuable than material wealth.
Chairman of Service to present his message, which includes the great message. They who is strongest and most powerful among us must also serve us all.
Service is born through work and need. God taught that his fatherhood led man's brotherhood. We are on holy service, aiding those in need, being there for others, being a friend for the friendless. Those are the aims of the unselfish. On the other hand, I remind you that selfishness is the great sin of the world, and service is its only cure. By serving others, you bring happiness, comfort, and peace into the lives of the others. I remind you, he who is greatest among them must be servant of all.
Now that you've heard from the chairman's scholarship and service, I invite the chairman of leadership to present their message.
Be thankful
forked tongues, bloody teeth, supplications, betrayals, the remote idea of the Milky Way. It remembers yesterday, and the river moves on. So Caddo Jim is trying to tell us that the memories of war at some point need to be set aside and remain dormant, and life will move on. Yes, the shedding of blood happened, the tears, all those things happened. But he believed, in his belief was, that God would help him to move on. In some languages, words are pictures. So in one of the languages, the person or situation that you can't forgive is literally tied to your back with a rope.
So the burden is very heavy.
And you're leaning over the rope. And the word forgive means that the rope is untied and you're able to stand up and move on. It doesn't mean the person was not guilty. It means that you have chosen to forgive and you're able to move on free of that bondage that you put yourself in. I was visiting with Mr. Sullivan recently. We go back a long ways. When I traveled with the fencers for years, I was Aunt Deborah, my husband was Uncle Buddy. And so Mr. Sullivan and I were just sitting down and talking. And we were discussing the recent acts of racism and towards blacks and toward the Chinese. And racism has always been here. We must rise up against hate. We must not be silent. We must acknowledge that there is disparity. But if we hate the haters, we are also haters. So we must stand together. I want to give you the third philosophy, which is give and serve. More than a billion people in our world today live on less than a dollar a day. So looking at us right here, we are very wealthy. 12 days in India changed my whole life. Because in those 12 days, there were two of them that I was somewhere with only the water that I had for those 2 days. It scared me. Because I knew that where I was, I did not have water available to me that I could drink. When I came back, we started doing pancake breakfast in October, which we hope to begin again, start back up next year, to raise money. The National Honor Society has paid for 7 wells in India, 1 well in China, and several wells that we have refurbished in Cambodia and Thailand and Vietnam. This excerpt from a letter is so powerful. It's from Shalu. I am a daily wage laborer. We used to walk nearly a kilometer to fetch water for an open well that was often dry. Now we don't have to worry for water. Please convey our heartfelt thanks to the donor, Caddo Parish, Magnet High, for their precious gift. We will remember them for the rest of our lives. Sometimes we send money, sometimes we go. So be thankful, forgive, serve. During quarantine, I began writing some poetry, and one of them was about advice that I might have. I'm getting to the age where I can give advice. And so I have several versions of it. But recently I've rewritten and added. And I titled this one, Advice for Seniors 2021. I think it applies to all of us. My mama said, make your bed up every day, because at least you will accomplish something, and that may be all you accomplish. My papa said, even a blind paw finds an acorn. So don't give up. Smiling can save life. It gives hope and confidence, and it makes people feel important. And they always are. Be thankful. When you're thankful, people like you better. When you're thankful, you like other people better. Be calm. I learned a long time ago, if you look like you know what you're doing, and you act like you know what you're doing, it makes everybody else feel better. Be kind. Do you want to be remembered for your kind words or your harsh words? It's harder to be kind, but those who are not lonely. Think before you speak. Act rather than react. Forgive so you can heal. Do not hold grudges. They will burn you. What have you learned from this past year? Your generation has an important task. Stand up against racism. Address global warming. Make sacrifices to save our world. Do you want to be a great leader? Learn to follow. Do you want to be a strong leader? Listen to others. Do you want to be a dynamic leader? Serve others. Lead by example. Always think about what you can do to help others, not what you can get out of it. Then you will make a difference, and the world will be a better place. And that is my advice. Let's move on to the actual induction. You've heard a lot of people talk.
Before we do that, she doesn't know I'm doing this, obviously. Personal privilege. This won't take long. I just want all of you to join with me, and I would like it if you would stand to do this, and give Ms. Moorhead a round of applause, one for doing this, and even more importantly, for being that model and being the person that she is. Remember, forgiveness.
Thank you so much. I love what I do. Okay, we're going to present to the audience our candidates who have listened to all of this that we have said and now seek approval for their entrance into the membership. Will this year's candidates please stand? We didn't get to rehearse this, but in a minute I'm going to ask you a question, and you're supposed to answer, you can be assured. Okay. We welcome you into the membership of this society. Our country needs leaders of students of good character, unquestionable loyalty to responsibility, to high courage, trust in God. Can we be assured that you are determined to do all of this? Now, repeat after me the pledge to this society. I pledge myself to uphold, the high purpose of this society, to which I have been elected, striving in every way, by word and deed, to make its ideals, the ideals of my school, and of my life. Well, we greatly have to say anything else. We gratefully accept you into the chapter of the National Honor Society, and you may be seated. Now we're going to do our induction where I will call out names, and then Mr. Elton Fritz will present the certificate. Delta Berlin, Lotto Bangkok. Kemi Elizabeth Bay. Jeremy Kami Vayner. Shayana Beatty. Sherry K. Belcher. Ananya Bhatia. Ananya Sarinti Brown. Ashley Danielle Brown. Gabriel Nicole Brown. Nathaniel Frederick Brown. Luke Daniel Brunson.
Andrew Peter Holden. Jack Miller Netherton. May Marie Otherzak. Naria Pavlar. Rowan Palmier.
Everybody in here.